We are the Guardians of Knowledge. Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2, guys. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Hi. We're checked around pretty much everything. Well, we haven't seen this guy yet. The tribal. We haven't gone that far. You know, it seems silly. I don't want to forget about him. Because we pretty much explored everything else outside. Oh, someone open that door. Probably one of my companions. We have not talked to this tribal or looked at this stuff back here. This seems to be very hard to fix. Okay, there's some other people out here, so on the outskirts. Are you from the Arroyo tribe? Yes. Which I cannot answer you. The remains of a rat. That's a wall? I call that a car. So someone's struggling with something. There's a stubborn son of a bitch over here. Can I get through here? That's the question. A merchant? Check with the boss if you think you can help. I just can't get this thing working. A water pump. Oh, I remember fixing a water pump. In Fallout, the first Fallout, we needed junk. Vic has some junk. You see a really old water pump that appears to be broken. Pipes. Junk. This car is a little wet and cannot be repaired. Oh, just a little. Merchant. Ah, what a piece of shit. I'm a little busy right now. Do you need something, or are you just wasting my time? I don't mean to bother, but what seems to be the trouble here? The main water pump for the Abbey is busted. The damn thing was breathing its last the past few days, and now it's finally gone on. Finally got out. I'm a bit of a techie. Mind if I take a look? Sure, no one's stopping you. I'll see what I can do then. That's you again. Any luck? No, not yet. I'll get back to you if I do. Alright, should I try to use my tool then? Does nothing. Super toolkit. I'm not sure I've actually used one of these yet. Did that do nothing, or do we, like, not actually use that? It does nothing, right? It does nothing, that does nothing, right? Repair? You're going to need more than just your hands to fix this machine. Perhaps some tools would help with installing this part. I do have tools. You are not letting me use them. You say they do nothing. Do we need some special tools? The junk is almost washed away, let me just see. Yeah, no kidding. I can't get this thing working. Yeah, it does nothing. I don't suppose we need maybe the junk from him? Because that was worked in the first Fallout. Right, he doesn't have the junk. Who has the junk? You open the machine and look inside. You see a lot of rusty gears and motors. One of the motors has a crack in it. Investigate more. Upon closer inspection, you see that the crack is not the cause of the trouble, but rather the connection for where the wires go. The connectors seem to have burned out over the years of use. It's going to take a whole new motor, as well as a new set of wires to get this machine working again. Okay, we need a motor and wires. And we can find that stuff. Any luck? Actually, yes. I looked inside and it seems the motor is actually completely busted. The connections are shot, so we're going to have to get our hands on a new motor, as well as some wires to reconnect everything since the old wires are fried. The connectors are shot on the main motor, huh? Well, I got some wires here with me that will work, but not that specific motor. I'm sure Vault City has the part, though. Go down and speak with Harry in the main courtyard. Tell him Dave sent you. Damn motor is expensive, but he should give you a good deal. Alright. Whoa, hold on a second. I was happy to help you figure out the problem, but who said I'm willing to trek across the wastes to go buy him an expensive motor? If you want my help, it's going to cost you. Alright, I wouldn't expect someone to do the work for free. The part will cost you about 500, and I think 100 more for your trouble is reasonable. Here's 600. Oh, he just already gave it to me. That's better. I'll be back with the part. Any luck on that part? This machine won't fix itself. I'll be back when I get it. Alright. Alright, so I thought we might need the junk, but not true. Oh, we can also go this way. Oh, we can see inside the place like this. Now there's at least three floors. The leader is on the third floor. But one day, men shall arrive above their destruction and the memorabilia will be there awaiting reintroduction. Sounds like it's rapping. What else did I say? So we tend to our holy task, lest all that wisdom we lose. Oh, just barge right in. Sure they'll be happy to see you. So now, go now, my friends, and let your spirits be lifted. He's just wandering all around. For the guardians of knowledge, we have each been gifted. How did I know he was going to rhyme that? Now please take a moment and reflect on what I have said. For if you don't, you surely will be dead. That's it? Yeah, let's take a look in here. Welcome to the Abbey. You be careful out there in the wastes. Welcome, stranger. You smell. Nice weather. Yeah, I'm not gonna mess with the poor box. It's a normal podium for public speaking. A simple altar made from painted wood. Burning brazier, full of burning coals. This lamp looks like it's in good working condition. This looks just like you would expect it to. Nothing special about this pew. This seat is supported by large concrete bricks. That's not important, but you're the one who looked. This place is so nice. Middle-aged monk, peace to you. Greetings, friend. I don't think I have seen you around here before. My name is Brother Matthew, and I help spread the word about the importance of preserving the knowledge of the old ones. Why am I still asking about this? It's good to meet you, Matt. My name is Andrea King, and I am on a quest for the Holy Geck. A Geck, huh? I seem to remember reading something about that during one of my transcribing sessions, so it must be in our database, but I'm afraid access to our computers is restricted. However, if you talk to the abbot, it's possible he'll grant you access. Couldn't hurt to try, anyway. Oh, and feel free to browse through our collection of holy pre-war relics. I'd ask you not to damage anything, but I'm afraid everything is already broken beyond repair. I think I just might. I have some questions, though. I'm at your service. What would you like to know? What can you tell me about this place? The Abbey is home to anyone, so long as they don't cause trouble. We are an independent community and rarely get visitors such as yourself. The majority of those you see here are descended from the original founders that settled in this old monastery not long after the Great Flame Deluge. Yeah, we know what that is, right, guys? This quiet, peaceful quality of this place has made it an appealing home to other travelers that have wandered here over the years, seeking to escape from the dark chaos of the wastes. Of course, the true value of this place lies in its vast library. It's filled with old tomes containing the strange wisdom of a lost age. Over time, we've come to fancy ourselves the keepers and guardians of that wisdom. Very interesting. Another question. You seem to be very poetic in your preaching. Any reason for this? The man chuckles at your question. No, no particular reason. I have just read much poetry throughout my life, and I greatly enjoy applying it to my teachings. It helps leave a greater impact on those listening. Fair enough. Take care. Good people of the Abbey, take a moment to listen, for I have much to say. Okay, the beginning of his sermon. Here we collect the holy relics of an age long past. Scorched by the flame deluge, into the dark we were cast. A memorabilia we shall make to preserve the wisdom of old. We must guard and care for it, though the flame has gone cold. Wedgie, in the middle of that. It could ignite once again, should the wisdom be misused. Thus no one shall learn for fear of another flame deluge. For one day men shall rise above their desire for destruction. And the memorabilia will be there, awaiting reintroduction. This is where we tuned in. So we attend to our holy task, lest all that wisdom we lose. We must preserve and protect it, but never shall we use. That's why they won't use it. So now, my friends, go now, my friends, and let your spirits be lifted. Something, something gifted. For the guardians of knowledge, we have each been gifted. Now please take a moment and reflect on what I have said. Nobody doesn't say anything after that. Kind of frustrates me. Like, you have another rhyme waiting for you. Ripe for the plucking. Stone bench. There's a guy in here. Greetings. Her back is turned. Only but the power of the save game do I dare. Hey, hey. First aid book and a stim pack. Oh, there's a guy standing right there looking at us. Jack, the Abbey's medic. I'm gonna knock on the desk. How can I help you? So what do you do here at the Abbey? I'm a doctor. I've been tending to the people of this Abbey, for about 15 years now, I believe. I see, that's quite a lot of years to study all the pre-war medical books in the Abbey's library. You must be quite the doctor. He frowns. I fancy myself a fine doctor, but I can't credit the books for that since I'm not even allowed to... Never mind, I won't get into that. My father was a doctor and he passed his knowledge down to me. You're not allowed to do something. I see. Where'd you get all your medical equipment? Some of these meds I received from my father. Most of the rest were already here at the Abbey. Do you think you could give me some of your meds? You seem to have plenty to spare. You want me to just give them to you? What makes you think you deserve them more than the people of the Abbey? Because I tend to get hurt. A lot. Actually, fine, would like buy them from him. Then perhaps you should learn to be more careful. So I'm not just going to give away the Abbey's medical supplies. And he won't sell them either. Okay. Fine, goodbye. I'm stuck. Thank you. Nothing there. Oh, there's a guy right there. Hope you enjoy your stay here. I don't want that stuff. That's empty. Mm. Alright, first floor done. A finely constructed wooden door, reinforced with ornate metal braces of an almost hypnotic design. I don't know, for some reason I just felt like looking at that door. Is there a way down as well? Yes, we've gone down. A coffin. Operations manual. Ooh. The operations manual to the KV-75, a portable tactical cryptographic device, also used by non-tactical users for high-level communications in the local wideband telephone networks and wideband satellite terminals. I can use this. What does this give you? Be the repair or science, I would think. Repair 83, science 84. It's curious. That does nothing. Huh. And you're right, did nothing. So is this the famed library, or part of it? Hold on. There's a lot of junk around here. Who's got the wedgie, Marcus? This guy needs a lighter. Fire pit. Could someone bring me a lighter? Where did I put my lighter? Greasy monk. Hey buddy, do you have a lighter on you? Yep. And your lighter. This is perfect, thanks. Out of curiosity, what exactly are you doing here? We brew our own alcohol here at the monastery. Some of the most powerful stuff you'll taste in the wastes. Oh, that's what Father Tully wants some. Mind if I try some? Sure, since you brought me a lighter, here's one on the house. I'm gonna hold on to it. Bottle of wine. A fresh bottle of Abbey's finest wine that weighs 1 pound. Okay, this is for Father Tully in New Reno, then. I'd like to buy some of the alcohol you make here. $20 a bottle, no, never mind. How about this guy? Greetings. Tubs. The bathtub is broken and cracked. It says alcohol, not books. All right. It's like a jail cell? Turned into a storage unit? Generator or stairs up. A lot of junk. Where do the stairs go? Been in this room? What is this? Oh, that's gross. There's just a bathroom here. Alright, back down. Good people of the Abbey, take a moment to listen, for I have much to say. Oh, is this from upstairs? Oh, we got going over here. Mushrooms. This table planter has been filled with dung and mushrooms are happily growing in it. Metal barrels. A pile of wood with some rusty useless nails embedded deeply. Let's take care of these things. Hi. Oh, I forgot to give myself a weapon. Positive lock on target confirmed. Marcus was it. How about stop hitting Marcus? He just joined our little group, and you're shooting him. Where'd they go? Let's get on. Talk about overkill. Can't move fast for some reason. Is this behind? Can I walk in here? Oh. Oh. You enter a dark cave, you have creatures scurrying about. The remains of the Abbey Doctor. Alright, why not? Come on, get out of here. Call that a hit? Let me show you how it's done. I can't hit these. Maybe now I can. There we go. They are not interested in you, Marcus. That's sad. Oh, yeah, you got that one. It looks at his watch. It's doing it again. It won't let me... Negative 15% chance of it. Okay, never mind. We're just gonna reload and move forward. Slowly, for some reason. Even though I was holding down shift. I didn't kill it? There you go. All right, Dead Abbey Doctor. Some gold and a knife. Where are we? Abbey Cave. Let me guess, this comes up underneath the well. I wanted to look at it. You see a mean-looking deathclaw. This one is tough. 310 hit points. It is breathing slowly and loudly, covered with scars. A huge deathclaw covered with scars. Okay, so this is like a weak deathclaw? Doesn't seem weak. Alright, get ready for the pain. I love the sound of tearing flesh, don't you? Since it is a deathclaw, it might. Gun, meet enemy. Enemy, meet gun. So what happened here? Deathclaw was critically hit for 42 hit points. Even this beast seems fazed by that stunning attack. Oh, I can't. Hope you have medical insurance. You're going to need it. He does hit pretty well. 500 experience points for killing the beast. So is this our culprit? Oh, is this what we got? A little baby one coming? Small, tough deathclaw. Imagine this fist down your throat. Still alive? Not anymore. That was a baby deathclaw. Maybe the baby one was going after the dead bodies. Okay, let's let my attic self, go this way. A dead child male. Carrying nothing. A dead monk. Oh, Ode to the Flame Deluge. Interesting. Scattered human bones. Are these human? Is that a question? Looking for a ladder up to a well? No. Not over here. Can't even get over there. That's nothing, right? All right. Hmm. Okay, that's it for the cave. Alright. Wasn't as big as I thought it was gonna be. So I wonder if I can ask him about the Abbey doctor now we found. What is this? You should talk to our leader if you wish to gain any information. There's so much work that needs to be done. And stop moving around. Where'd you go? Are you behind us? Oh. Guys. Thank you. Hey, thanks again for the lighter. It's better than my old one. So where's the doctor? The doctor's upstairs, isn't he? I'm injured. Can you help me? It is done. Thanks. Am I completely fine? Alright. Yeah, no option to ask about the other doctor. Alright, let's go back. Scorched by the Flame Deluge. Oh, that's part of the sermon from above. Up above. A novel set after a devastating nuclear war. The book excerpt describes how a violent backlash against the culture of advanced knowledge and technology that had led to the development of nuclear weapons took place shortly after this war. Anyone of learning, and eventually anyone who could even read, was likely to be killed. Does nothing. Hmm. Now, how heavy are these books? Am I close to... I got 50 more pounds. I'm okay for now. Interesting books. I wish we can actually read them. You know, they were actually books. You know, they could read for a little bit. But no. Oh, sorry. We've been over here. We have not been... Oh, we have. But I need to make my way over here somehow. Which is... I can't get there from here. I need to get there from another staircase, evidently. Okay. Yeah, so let's go up. Need some healing over there, huh? That's a good question. How do we get down there? Maybe we have to go up to go down. Second floor. Oh my.